Hey Internet, my name is Abby and welcome back to the Coffee Break in Minecraft. Today is Wednesday, February 11th, 2015, and down there next to my smelting system is a creeper, and well, up there next to the view monument is a second creeper, so I hope I can approach the first creeper without getting backstabbed by a third one. And yeah, okay, let me now sneak up on him. Okay, and now I can shoot him. And one, okay, very good. And two, okay, and now it's time for the diamond sword to finish this guy off. And well, he is ignoring me. That's also a good opportunity for me to sneak up on him. And now I like to grab these fresh bricks in order to create some more material for my house. And can I... Oh, I can use them all at once. This is cool. Okay, I want to have something like this. Very good. Okay, 46 stones. Not bad. Then I do have several or a lot of oak wood planks. I think these are also quite useful to create the ceiling for my house. And yeah, now I need to climb up and I hope I'm not running into the creeper. Or well, if I run into him, I can stop him from exploding so that we are not damaging the viewer monument. This would be really problematic, but okay, I think the creeper is gone. I think the creeper just despawned. And yeah, then I'm not quite sure, but I think today I will be releasing my she video here, the video. All the footage I took while I was skiing on Friday is now processed, and now I have a short 3-minute video. And well, it took a little bit longer than anticipated because I hope I have enough wood to create the ceiling, because there are several issues. On the one hand, of course, the video itself is quite shaky because somehow I needed to record while I was skiing downhill, and while I was doing this, of course, there was some shakiness going on, and you can see this shakiness in the video. And well, it's not so much of a problem. Well, sure, it's a little bit of a problem. I hope my viewers aren't getting seasick when they are watching this video. But yeah, there are also some other solutions, like using some stabilizers tools to reduce the shakiness. But after I used these things, I ran into the problem that the whole quality was then reduced. And well, this was then the decision between, okay, I am able to see all the interesting features and then I have to accept the shakiness, or I reduce the shakiness but then the video seems to be a little bit blurred. And yeah, this was then a little bit problematic, and well, I came to the decision, okay, I like the details, so I decided I will release the shaky video, and I hope you're not getting seasick by watching this. I noticed when I am watching this just in the usual YouTube window without maximizing it, then it was not so bad, but it was a little bit strange as I was watching it full screen. And well, then there is another problem, because YouTube is all the time basically re-rendering my video. And well, the first times I did this, the YouTube had basically increased the shakiness. I'm not quite sure how YouTube has done this, but YouTube has managed to increase the shakiness of the video, and well, this was totally bad. And so I had to re-render it several times until YouTube until YouTube stopped messing around with my video. And at some point I really wished that YouTube would stop using their stupid render, because all the time I even have some issues was for example the Long Dark videos, because during Long Dark we are often in some darker environments, like exploring a house or exploring a cabin or something like this, and yeah, then I upload this to, or well, I watch the video on my own computer, it looks okay, I upload it to YouTube renders it and re-render the video, and then I'm totally disappointed because it's so dark, and I wish there would be the option like, okay, please stop your own post-processing process and just accept the quality I'm delivering to you. But no, YouTube refuses this. And yeah, all in all, this caused the delay in the release of my ski video, but today it's time to release it, and in the upcoming days I'm then also able to release the hiking videos, or the winter hiking videos I recorded. And yeah, I just had not the enough time to do this, and then I thought, okay, at first I like to create the ski video, now I finished this, and now I'm working on the next, or on the first hiking video, and I think it will be quite okay. I'm quite surprised by the resulting video I have created so far. But I need to improve it just a little bit more. But yeah, I think this is also a very nice project. And yeah, so this will happen today. And then, speaking about today, oh well, no, I think the topic for today will come soon, because at first, yeah, on Friday I was skiing, I already talked about this, but yesterday evening I saw on the webcam of this hill, okay, there is still of course a lot of snow, because down here in my town we had some light rain and the snow starts to melt, but up there the snow is stable. And so I thought, okay, before it gets worse up there too, I should go skiing. And so I was skiing in the floodlight, and well, this is all the time so amazing, because the floodlight adds a totally different experience to skiing. And yeah, skiing in the nighttime and being in the floodlight, this is so amazing. And I had a lot of fun, and well, this was really cool being out there and yeah, doing the whole ski stuff. But I'm not quite sure, I haven't recorded any video footage, because I think it was a little bit too dark to record anything during the nighttime. And maybe I can take advantage of this misplaced block to add some light, so that it's not too dark in here and we have spawning mobs or so. I will just light up a few parts of my new house, just in case, or just to be sure that there are no monsters spawning in here and surprising me by exploding on me or doing whatever these guys are doing. And yeah, maybe I will keep or leave this part open right now, so that I can get out there like this, and this should allow me to get up here. Very good. So now I can create another wall. This is good. Okay, yeah, so I was skiing in the floodlight, and well, this is all the time so beautiful and so amazing, and it's just amazing to be out there and being skiing and so on. And wow, oh, this is really a nice vantage point. This is so amazing. And yeah, okay, now we are out of material. What else? So yeah, topic for today is the launch of the IXV, the intermediate experimental vehicle. It's a space plane, a robotic space plane built by the European Space Agency and launched by the European Space Agency on top of a Vega rocket from French Guiana. And yeah, I'm so amazed, and I'm looking so much forward to this rocket launch, because it's so cool to, on the one hand, to see the new space plane, or the test space plane, to yeah, for future maybe return missions from space, so that we can take advantage once again of a space plane. And yeah, so the whole mission will have a duration of 102 minutes. The space plane will be launched on a suborbital trajectory, but it will be launched almost at the velocity you will need to enter orbit around the Earth. So in this case, yeah, it's pretty close to be orbiting around the Earth. And yeah, then the thing will basically fly all around the world and return and have a splashdown in the Pacific Ocean. And well, all it's well, the whole launch is all about testing the re-entry mechanism, because it's well, a lifting body, and it uses on the one hand some thrusters to control its attitude, and as soon as it gets into the denser parts of the atmosphere, it will extend some two flaps at the back of the space plane in order to control the descent, and also to perform some basically some S turns in order to reduce the speed and in order to reduce the altitude, and to finally have a parachute-assisted splashdown in the Pacific Ocean. And well, I think this is really a cute project. And well, I'm also pretty amazed, because it's an European project. Well, I'm interested in all the upcoming space projects, like okay, like the Dragon 2.0, or the Boeing capsule, or the Orion project, or well, I'm not quite sure. The Russian side is currently working on a new space launch system. The Was it called the Angara rocket? I think it was called the Angara rocket. And yeah, so everyone is making some progress, but well, as a European, I'm really happy that also Europe is doing some nice progress. And well, they already did a great thing in the last year with the landing on the Comet 67P with the Rosetta spacecraft. This was pretty cool, and this was the first time that a robotic mission landed on a comet. And well, this was an European project, and now we have a space plane. And well, this is also so amazing. And of course, space planes aren't new. We had the space shuttle, we have this I'm not quite sure how the thing was called. I forgot the name, but this Air Force space plane, robotic space plane thingy. I forgot the name, but the thing which stayed for over 2 years or so in space and returned in the last year. Then this thing is going on. Then Sierra Nevada was experimenting with their Dream Catcher, Dream Chaser, also an idea for a space plane. But for the European Space Agency, it's the very first time that they are gaining some experience with a space plane, and so it's so amazing, and I can't wait for the launch. And here, the launch is currently scheduled for 13 GMT, and they have or the launch window extends for 1 hour and 40 minutes or so. So in case that there is a problem during the launch preparations or during the countdown, they can just maybe they can fix it so that they can still perform the launch. And yeah, so I hope it will work, and that they will be able to launch it on time without having any issues, and that the whole intermediate experimental vehicle flight test will be a total success. And yeah, hey, the cow is on my bed. The cow is standing on my bed. Okay, that's interesting. And yeah, so I'm really looking forward to this, and I'm really excited to follow these. Okay, I finished my lava patch for my volcano. This is cool. And well, I think at some point I like also to explore a little bit the cave I discovered in the last episode, the cave where I placed the sign caution danger. And yeah, I think I like to descend down into the depth of this cave, ouch, in order to see what is down there. Maybe I can find some useful materials also. But I'm not quite sure. I don't think I will do this in this episode, but maybe in the next episode we will go caving. I will create a few ladders so that I'm able to descend down. And then we will see what we can find down there. And yeah, so space plane. I'm really looking forward to the launch and to the live coverage. And yeah, so and well, it's also quite impressive when you think about the whole space plane has the size of a car, and well, you are shooting your car up into space, then the car is flying all around the world and is returning at a velocity almost like the velocity when you're returning back from, or maybe it's almost the velocity you will have when you're returning back from space and or from orbit. And well, this is so cool, and here I can't wait for the result. And then speaking about space launches, I was talking about the Discover satellite, the sun radiation experiment, where was the launch on top of a Falcon 9 rocket and out to the L1 point, the Lagrange point. And here, until now, the launch was all the time scrapped, because at first, the first launch attempt was on Sunday evening. There was a problem with the range radar, I guess. And yeah, then yesterday they wanted to do a new launch attempt, but this time they had some issues with high altitude winds, so the winds were too strong, and so they exceeded the structural limits for the Falcon 9 rocket, and in this case they had to scrap it again. And well, I think today this evening is the last chance to launch the satellite, and if they are not able to do this today, then they need to wait for, I don't know, I think it was 1 week, 2 weeks, because there's then some other issues that they are not able to launch the satellite, because I think there's something problematic with the trajectory or so. I haven't done all the research on these issues, but yeah, if they're not able to do this today, then they have to wait for a few days until they can try there, or they can do the next launch attempt. And yeah, so a lot of things are going on. Then, of course, yesterday the Dragon capsule was released from the ISS and it returned back to Earth. It had a good splashdown, and all the experiments and all the cargo was recovered. So this is cool. And speaking about capsules and the release of capsules, on Saturday we will have the release of the ATV. Currently the automated transfer vehicle from Europe is still mated with, or still docked to, the International Space Station, and on Saturday it will be leaving. And then I need to check on my calendar. At the end of the month, yes, on February 27th, the ATV-5 will perform its re-entry, and they will try out a different re-entry trajectory, because they want to see how huge masses behave, or yeah, they basically want to use the ATV, the re-entry of the ATV, in order to gain some insights how they could maybe deorbit the International Space Station once the ISS project is finished. And so they will perform a more or less shallow re-entry trajectory in order to see how then everything is behaving, and how the ATV will break up. And what is even very cool about the re-entry of the ATV and the breakup, they will install some cameras even in the inside of the ATV, so you can see some video. I'm not quite sure if they are performing a live stream or if the footage is released later, but you are then able to see the basically the breakup of the ATV live. So you can see how maybe, I don't know, how the thing is shaking or how some parts are falling apart or maybe it starts to glow. I have no idea how it will look like when the ATV is performing its re-entry. But here, so they will install even some cameras to the inside, to the inside of the ATV, and I think this is very, very exciting, and this will happen, as I said, at the end of the month. But before this will happen, we will see the IXV, the Intermediate Experimental Vehicle, the maiden flight of it, and wow, I'm really amazed. I'm so amazed. As you've heard during the whole episode, I can't wait for this launch, and yeah, so I will follow it. And I hope everything will work as planned with their car-sized lifting body space plane thingy, and that they can gain some good insights into the whole space plane system, and maybe they can really pave the way into the future with space planes or so. I think this would be so amazing. And yeah, with this, the sun is setting. We are at the end of this episode. And in this case, I just can say thank you so much for watching. I hope you like this. I hope you have also the chance to follow all these rocket launches, IXV test, the ATV undocking, and so on. And yeah, in this case, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, my name is Abby. See you!